Hello and welcome back to Tharig Plays Blood Bowl 2. We are gonna play Orcs. Orcs. What happened last time? I don't remember. Oh yeah, we won 2-0. That's good. And that sounds rather cocky. I didn't really mean to sound like that. I actually didn't remember what the outcome was from last time. The exact outcome at least, so I apologize if that sounded weird. As always, long wait time, so see you in a moment. Okay, now this is interesting. 2,200 dwarves. What? Okay. So I'm kind of expecting a death roller for a change, because otherwise that team value would be insane. As always, I'm going to wait until it's my turn with the inducements. But yeah, this is... That's scary. I usually outguard our opponents, but I highly doubt that's gonna be the case here. Dwarves, once they basically start with guard. They really don't, but it's their second pick usually on a lot of their units, especially their linemen. It's Mighty Blow Guard. That's pretty much all they need. Nexus would be Stand Firm. Yep, there's the Deathroller. Three rerolls, an Apo, so... Oh god, all those SPPs. So a Deathroller with Guard. Just 12 players. Guard, dodge, mighty blow. Guard, mighty blow, stand firm. Guard, strength 4, mighty blow, dodge. Guard, dodge, mighty blow, strength 4. Guard, mighty blow, stand firm. We've got a runner with dodge, block, kick, fend. Okay. Both of these have piling on. One has plus movement. He has no injuries whatsoever on the team, so no nigglings or step busts. Anything. He does have the bribe for free, but since we don't see that, I'm the home team here. I've got a lot of petty cash, so we are gonna go with a wizard, and is a bribe really the right thing to do here? An apple would be the safe choice, but we're going in there. I could go bribe and apple, but I think I'm going and spend some of our own money, consequently, but I'm just going wizard, bribe, bape. We'll see. So the thing is, with him not having a bribe, his death roller is a limited time, I don't know, currency, if you want to call it that, something like that. I was trying to go somewhere and failed. Either way, he doesn't have a reserve player, so if I injure something, he has to set up the death roller, and the death roller will get sent off once. The death roller will get sent off once the drive is over or a touchdown has been scored, as long as he does not get a bribe. There is a kickoff event that will give him a bribe, but we'll have to wait and see if that shows up. And our opponent's name is El Huapo, I assume, and he's playing the Dread Cross. Really? Even if that was a joke, oh, come on, buddy. So as expected, everything has guard. Well, everything but two players? This guy has only Mighty Blow. This guy does not have guard either, but everything else has guard. Literally. And that means it's gonna get complicated. It's gonna get very complicated. This team is so well developed. He's got dodge, he's got 2 strength 4 players. It's gonna be tough. Dwarves are already not the easiest thing to handle, I think, at some point. Usually I cannot bash enemies because of the way our team works out. But with him, I'm not sure. The thing is, also the Troll Slayers have Dauntless, which will make it easier for him to hit the Black Orcs. And Fork, of course. We have 6 guard players. While he will have 10 on the pitch. We have 4 strength 4 players, which is going to help. But this is still Okay, he's not even setting up his runner, so he has 11 players with guard on the pitch. That's interesting. And he's setting up the death roller right away as well. And that is where it gets scary. And I have to decide if I want to... I have to decide if I want to set up my Dauntless player on the line of scrimmage. We could hit the Death Roller, but not easily. I need Tackle. No, we need the Agility 4 to be that person. Both of them have Dodge. This guy has Strength 4 as well. So I think what I'm gonna do... is something like this. Let's see. Does that work out as I want it to? I do have to put the Dauntless player on the line now, unfortunately. I don't need to, but I want to. That's what this plays out to in the end. I might as well bring them in like this. That's okay. Okay. I have no idea. This is gonna get so complicated. This is a 2... No, this is also strength 4. Yes, okay. I just barely noticed. Okay, let's go all in. Now I have 2 assists with my guard players. He's really committing on the line of scrimmage. Just wants to make sure that I can't knock it down easily. But now we have the capabilities, at least in theory. Of course we gotta get the ref. So I have 2 bribes now, and he has 1. Ah, this was the worst thing that could have happened to us. Well... Wow. Well, that's an opening that's gonna destroy us. Oh god, I roll into quadruple skulls. That's not good. First action was double skulls, rerolled into double skulls. And now the pain is going to commence. I hate this so much. So much. And with the bribe, the Death Roller is gonna stick around a lot longer than we want. Possibly the entire match. I don't know what to think of this right now. He can just fan out, use his guard to his advantage, and lock me down. I think I won't be able to do much about that. Because he has... his 2 strength 4 guys, with dodge. He has the Death Roller with strength 7 and guards. Just this was one of my only chances to get him, and now that's gone. That's good. That should mean... No, it doesn't mean a 1 dice. He can push me up there. It does mean a GFI though, so he's a reroll out of a reroll as well. Makes the second GFI though, and knocks me down. Big question is he willing to use his bribe to actually foul, or will he keep that for the Death Roller? He is gonna pile on here. That's already a bummer. And there goes Orchid, so I have to Apo. First turn into this match, and we are not looking good. We are not looking good, one bit. I hate this so much. So what do we do here? Right now, I feel very tempted to fireball. Because he's standing very compact and it would hit 5 players. And that could leave some damage, but usually when I do that, it just does nothing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Throw this away. We do have an option to just run to run along the sideline. I'm gonna hit 5, guys. Let's just do the dumb thing, sure. Sure, let's do the dumb thing. Let's hit some dwarves with a fireball. See if we can get an injury. Nope. As expected. Just nothing. Straight up. Isn't that lovely? So... This is a foul. This foul over here would be better, but I don't think we can get that. Hey, look at that, I got him down. We're gonna stay. I think I want to foul first. It won't get better than this. I mean, I do have 2 bribes now, so there's a little bit of an incentive to actually use them. We're gonna do this blitz next. He does have stand firm, so I'm not gonna push him away, I think. Okay, 2 stuns out of this is pretty good, though. And then I fail my ball pickup. It gets worse. I mean, we're still okay, but this is... It's dumb. It's so dumb. I would have gotten the ball, tried to get the ball over here, maybe. Maybe that wouldn't have been the right call. That's still 3 tackle zones, even with an basically, a strength 7 is meaningless on Dauntless, not on Dauntless, on Break Tackle, but Strength 6 isn't, I think, so this would be a 3+, I guess. But he probably still doesn't want to do that right away. But now he's putting pressure on me, and I think we should be able to move 1 or 2 players back to stay safe-ish. But I need to pick up the ball now and get away with it. I can't keep this up for much longer. This is such a weird opening, and the fireball, as usual, just does nothing for me. I mean, we knocked 2 guys down. That's useful, really. You're gonna do that. If he does that, I'm gonna hate him for it, and it works. Of course he does that. And it still is a 2 dice, because the strength is just too high. So the issue with that is now I can't move a player in for defense anymore. Well, I can, but just 1, and that's the one where I want the ball to be. This entire setup is, right now, disastrous. Oh, no, now he did me a favor. Now we actually have somebody who can receive the ball a lot better with Agility 4, so I'm no longer against the idea of bringing in him to save us there. Just gonna move him in the way. Let's see, 1 over here. Okay, so far. And these guys... Okay, he did not actually do anything over here, so that helps as well. Yeah, sure, let's give him that. 4, 5, 6, 7. I could have gotten... I still can get a 2 dice down there if I want to. But that's only... Maybe. And rather unlikely, I guess. Although what I could do is blitz like this. No, with him being there. If we bring this in, That's a one dice now, yes. Okay, so I'm gonna do this. It's obvious where I want to go. It looks like we're just doing that, and it all depends on whether or not we can make this work. Ah, come on! This is getting ridiculous right now. I'm happy that I pulled more than one player back. I'm happy that I didn't pull the Black Orc back as well. Because this guy still has a 2 dice against the strength 3 players. This is so bad. This is better. I assume it's gonna push me down here. No, okay. Into a skull. Okay, come on. Give me the double skull. Ah, he gives us the double skull. Oh, thank you, Lord. I'm not even religious, but thank you very much. Whatever. Oh, God. That was kind of important. Just a little bit, in case you were wondering. Okay, so the issue with this is I still need to secure this first, and we cannot do that if I cannot move, and all of these guys being knocked down, or not being knocked down, being close to this, just screws me over right now. Come on, he does have dodge. So we're pushing him over there. I'm gonna follow. Okay, here we go after this guy. Got it. Oh yeah, he's got stand firm as well. He's letting himself get pushed, though. I'm gonna follow, because I need to see if we get through the armor for a piling on. We did not, so I will not. Instead, we're gonna go down here. And I'm gonna foul this guy. He has only armor value 8, so it's a better chance for us to actually do something. And we did, but it wasn't enough. Let's see if I can finally pick up the ball. Hey, look at that, I can. And I know I'm out of position in a lot of ways. But I guess we'll see how it'll play out. So I'm gonna go all the way to the sideline. He cannot blitz me if I'm here. He can get a player next to me if he's really going for it. But only one player. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. The issue is I will not be able to catch up and defend him at all. So I maybe should have stayed back here. That was one of the options. But now he's got some resources down here. Less than I do. But still, and he needs to move. He did not stand up some of his guys before doing this that cost him his turn early on there. Such a weird match again. That start was horrible. The fireball was completely wasted. He got a bribe, so his death roller is going to stick around longer than I want to. He almost killed one of my best players on turn 1 or 2, whatever it was. And I failed to pick up 4 times because it was with rerolls. Very, very strange match overall so far. Okay, he is going for a blitz with a death roller. So he's not gonna move him afterwards. Okay, he just wanted to strengthen his position over here, I guess. So my plan right now is to score in 2 turns and foul the living crap out of this troll slayer in the meantime. I think. Seems like a reasonable plan to me. I do have two bribes. He might start fouling as well, which could be scary because he's got the Black Orcs as his, at his disposal. The thing is, I might have to score in one turn now if he... He does not bring this guy back. He is, in fact, going in for a foul. Without an assist? With just one assist? Something like that? Got through. Got a stun. Okay. Oh no, with two assists. These guys helped. Okay, he's dodging away with him. That's a good move, because if I want to block here, he will not use a stand firm, and I will be forced to follow into this in case I don't make it on the first one. So I can move out of their reach completely now. I'm going to do that first, and we're going to score next turn. We're going to bring in another assist down here for the foul. Come on, just give me what I need here. Another stun. It's not good enough right now. But that is okay as well right now. We'll go here. And there. That's gonna give me the assists that I need. Okay, one down. I assume he's just gonna stay there. There we go, got through. Got another stun, not good enough. And he could do some real damage with piling on, maybe, if we get lucky. Let's see what we get. Did not get through the armor, but I'm still gonna pile on here. I think we're in a safe enough position to risk that. Okay, did nothing. Was close, though, at least. And now these are all two dice against. And they all have stand firm, except for this one. I don't want to be knocked down. Yeah, I'm just gonna stay like this. Let's see about that. So the upside here is, because I'm gonna score, he's gonna have to use his bribe to keep the death roller on the pitch. But... Oh god, this is so good right now. That's two blocks without a knockdown on the same guy. But the drop, or not, the next good thing as well is that we're still in half one. Wow, he did not knock me down. That's a surprise. So to finish the thought, he will always have a turn 8 after my turn 8, because I received. And that means... If he does not prevent the score, holy crap. He does have pro there though, failed. Lucky, very lucky for us. Such a weird match. Let me actually finish this. It basically means the death roller will not be present in the second half as long as he doesn't get another bribe, because he has to use the bribe to keep it on the pitch the first time, and once the halftime's up, it's gonna get sent off regardless. And he realizes that, which is why he's kind of foul again, because he will not keep the death roller. And that's the reason why I want to injure one more of his players, so that he will be down to 10. At least one more. I'm trying to hit the ones that are squishy, if you want to call them squishy, because it's armor value 8. Doesn't get squishier for dwarves. We'll just have to wait and see. This turns into a little bit of a foul race, because he's gonna keep fouling, I'm gonna keep fouling, and at some point it will hurt somebody, and the likelihood of that of me getting hurt is higher than him getting hurt, because he has thick skull. So this guy can reach me now. Oh yeah, we have jump up on Orkin now, I forgot. I can't get a good blitz, but we can get a good foul down here, and I think I'm still gonna score then. And we'll see how that'll turn out. Bring him down to here. Just give me something good. Now, obviously, I'm going to get caught by the with the foul. I'm going to lose the bribe. Rolled a 1 on the bribe. There's the injury. Okay, nothing of that happened, so that works. Smashed hand. Is he going to apple that? I don't think so. Nope, he's not doing that. So he is down to more or less 10 players. I could stall this out longer, potentially, now. But now is where I'm going to do this. We're going to score. It gives him a little bit of time, but the death roller, he either has to spend the bribe to keep the death roll on the pitch for the remaining first half, which is 3 turns for him, I think. Or he has to play with 10 players. Oh, he rolled a 1 on the bribe, and then he gives up. Aww. The last with the Bretonians was already a concede. Really? 2,200 dwarves give up because their bribe failed. Isn't that a sight to behold? We got a level up. Awakening leveled up. Yeah, that's fine. I do hate this a little bit. So we're gonna do another orc match, because this one was under 30 minutes, at least with the Bretonians, we were closer to 40. But I don't know. So we have Mighty Blow, Tackle, Agility 4. I see 2 options here right now. We either go Guard. The main reason for that is that with Agility 4, I will be able to reposition that guard a lot better. And it's going to allow me to get assists where I usually wouldn't be able to as easily. And more guard is always nice. Or we go Dauntless. Once again, with Agility 4, it might allow us to get a better blitz at some areas. And that could be helpful. But Dauntless, I mean, it's not that situational. It always can apply on blocking against higher strength opponents. But I think I'm going to go with guard in this case. Yeah. Okay, this match was so weird. I'm very happy that we managed to save the Blitzer. That would have annoyed me to no end, Orchid here, if we had lost him. And then he conceded. But, ah well. So I'm going to do another Orc match next time. I'm sorry that it was this short. Nothing I can do there. We're actually at, 39 matches now. So the next one will be the 40 match mark. So we are 4-5th. Through with the orcs for now, and they're still going strong. Just this entire thing is I'm still amazed at how well am I doing with them. But yeah, I'm okay with it. So let's keep this going, and thank you all very much for watching. I hope you still enjoyed this episode. If you did, please leave a like in the comment, and if you want to see me play more Blood Bowl 2, just stick around. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you will tune in next time, and have a nice day. Bye.